Hello everyone and welcome back to Georgina's World. So in today's video we are going to learn the names of job in Italian language and we are going to take a look at the most used tense when it comes to work. So it's going to be easier for us to express ourselves when we are looking for a job and we will be able to explain which kind of job we are looking for and in which area we are specialized. So we are going to start by learning the most used terms when it comes to work. Here with me, I have two lists. In the first list, we have the most the terms used when it comes to work, both in English and in Italian. And also, we have the list of the jobs name, both in English and in Italian. So I'm going to leave the pictures of the list in the comment sections. So in the comment section, so you can save it on your phone and you can study it at home. And if you also want the PDF, so you can also print it, you can contact me privately. So I'm going to have the list here with me and so I can read it and I can translate everything for you. So let's start. The word work in Italian is lavoro. So work is lavoro. Then we have employment, which is impiego. So employment in Italian is impiego. Then we have to work. So to work in Italian is lavorare. To work in Italian is lavorare. Then we have worker, which is lavoratore. So worker is lavoratore. Then we have job, which in Italian is mestiere. So job in Italian is mestiere. Then we have profession, which in Italian is professione. Profession is professione. Then we have wages or salary, which in Italian is called stipendio or salario. So wage or salary is salario or stipendio. Salario or stipendio. Then we have increase, which in Italian is aumento. Of course, increase, we are talking about the salary in this case because we are talking about the work environment. So increase of salary is aumento di stipendio. So increase of salary is aumento di stipendio. Then we have to earn, which is guadagnare. To earn is guadagnare. And to save is risparmiare. So to save in Italian is risparmiare. Then we have money, which in Italian is denaro or simply soldi. So money is denaro or soldi. Denaro or soldi. Then we have cash, which is contanti. Cash is contanti. Then we have to retire, when it's time for someone to stop working because of the age. So in that case is to retire, which in Italian is andare in pensione. To retire is andare in pensione. And the person that retires is pensionato. So to retire is andare in pensione. And the person that retires is pensionato. Pensionato. Then we have to sell, which is vendere. To sell is vendere. And to buy is comprare. To buy is comprare. Then we have, if we are looking for a full-time job, and then we don't know how to say full-time job, it's very easy. In Italian, we just have to say lavoro full-time. So the full-time is going to be the same. We just have to add at the beginning of the statement lavoro. So lavoro full-time. And if we are looking for a part-time job, we just have to say lavoro part-time. So then job interview in Italian is colloquio di lavoro. So job interview is colloquio di lavoro. Then we have job offer, which in Italian is offerta di lavoro. So job offer is offerta di lavoro. Then we have work day. Work day in Italian is giornata di lavoro. So work day in Italian is giornata di lavoro. Then we have to apply for. So since we are talking about things when it comes to work, we are clearly talking about applying for a job. So to say to apply for a job is candidarsi per un lavoro. So is candidarsi per un lavoro, or we can also say fare domanda per un lavoro. So is either candidarsi per un lavoro o fare domanda per un lavoro. Then we have working conditions. So before we start a new job, there are the working conditions, and in Italian is condizioni di lavoro. Condizioni di lavoro. So working conditions in Italian is condizioni di lavoro. Then we have internship. When we are working and they are paying us small money because they are teaching us the work, so we are learning the job, is called internship, and in Italian is tirocinio. So in Italian, internship is tirocinio, and the person that is doing the internship in Italian is tirocinante. So internship is tirocinio, and the person doing the internship is tirocinante. So if we want to say that we are looking for a job, then we can say sono alla ricerca di un lavoro. So I am looking for a job in Italian is sono alla ricerca di un lavoro. Sono alla ricerca di un lavoro. And then if we are looking for a temporary job, then in Italian is called lavoro a tempo determinato. So if we are looking for a temporary job, which is a job that can last 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, any amount of time when the job is going to expire, so we know when the job is going to expire, is called temporary job, and in Italian is lavoro a tempo determinato. And the contract for this specific job is called contratto a tempo determinato. Contratto a tempo determinato is the contract that is made for this kind of job, which is temporary job. And if we are looking for a permanent job, in Italian is called lavoro a tempo indeterminato. So permanent job in Italian is lavoro a tempo indeterminato, which is a job that is permanent, so it doesn't have really an expiring date. And the contract that is made for this kind of job is called contratto a tempo indeterminato. So this is all about the most used terms when it comes to work. Now we are going to learn about the names of jobs in Italian language. So let's start with the first one, which is accountant, which in Italian is contabile. Accountant, contabile, or ragioniere. So accountant can be said in two different ways, which are contabile or ragioniere. Then we have actor, which is attore, and attore is for male. And then we have actress, which is female, and in Italian is attrice. So actor is attore and actress is attrice. Then we have architect, which is architetto. So architect is architetto. Then we have baker, which is panettiere or fornaio. And those are the ones that are doing bread. Then we have banker, which is banchiere. So banker is banchiere. Then we have barber, which is barbiere. So barber is barbiere. Then we have barman and barmaid, which in English is barman for the male and barmaid for the female. But in Italian, it's just one word, which is barista, and is used both for female and male. So in Italian is barista. Then we have bodyguard, which is guardia del corpo. So bodyguard is guardia del corpo. Then we have builder, those who are working in construction work. So in Italian is operaio edile. In Italian is operaio edile, or simply muratore. So the simplest way to say builder is muratore. Then we have bus driver, which is autista di autobus. So bus driver is autista di autobus. Then we have nanny. So nanny is badante. So nanny is badante. Then we have carpenter, which in Italian is falegname. So carpenter in Italian is falegname. Then we have cleaner, which in Italian is addetto or addetta. So addetto is for the male, addetta is for the female, and is addetto alle pulizie. So for male, addetto alle pulizie, and for female is addetta alle pulizie. Addetta alle pulizie. Then we have comedian. So in Italian is comico. We have cook, which in Italian is cuoco. So cook is cuoco. Then we have dancer, which in Italian for male is ballerino, and for female is ballerina. Then we have dentist, which in Italian is dentista. So dentist in Italian is dentista. We have detective, which in Italian is investigatore. So detective in Italian is investigatore. For male and for female is investigatrice. I know the word is a little bit long, but the more you practice, the more it's going to be easier. So detective for male is investigatore, and for female is investigatrice. Then DJ, also in Italian, is DJ. Then we have doctor, which in Italian is either medico, so doctor, medico, or simply dottore for male. So for male is dottore, and for female is dottoressa. So medico, we have two different ways to say it in Italian, which is medico, or we can say dottore for male and dottoressa for female. Then we have driver, which in Italian is autista. So driver in Italian is autista. Then we have electrician, which in Italian is elettricista. So electrician in Italian is elettricista. Elettricista. Then we have engineer, which in Italian is ingegnere. So engineer in Italian is ingegnere. Then we have farmer, which in Italian is contadino. So farmer is contadino. Then we have fashion designer, which in Italian is stilista di moda. Stilista di moda. And also we have fishman, which is pescivendolo. Fishman in Italian is pescivendolo. We have as well flight attendant, which in Italian is assistente di volo. So flight attendant in Italian is assistente di volo. So we also have florist, and those are the ones selling flowers, and in Italian is fioraio. So florist in Italian is fioraio. We also have gardeners, which are those who working in gardens, and in Italian is called giardiniere. So gardener in Italian is giardiniere. Then we have greengrocer, which are those who are selling fruit and vegetable, and in Italian is fruttivendolo. So in Italian, greengrocer is fruttivendolo. Then we have hairdresser, which for female in Italian is parrucchiera, and for male is parrucchiere. So hairdresser in Italian for female is parrucchiera, and for male is parrucchiere. Then we have housewife, which in Italian is casalinga. So housewife in Italian is casalinga. Then journalist in Italian is giornalista. So it's not really much different from the English word, because in English is journalist, and in Italian, as I said, is giornalista. Then we have judge, which in Italian is giudice. So judge in Italian is giudice. Then we have lawyer, which in Italian is avvocato. Lawyer in Italian is avvocato. Then we have mechanic, which in Italian is meccanico. Mechanic is meccanico. As you see, as you can hear, I mean, the difference is not a lot from the English word and the Italian word. Then we have model, which in Italian for male, model is modello, and for female is modella. Then we have musician, which in Italian is musicista. So musician in Italian is musicista. Then we have babysitter, which in Italian is the same, which is babysitter. Only a small pronunciation difference, because in English is babysitter and in Italian is babysitter, but it's the same. Then we have nurse, which in Italian is infermiera for female. Nurse in Italian for female is infermiera, and for male is infermiere. So for female is infermiera, and for male is infermiere. Then we have painter, which in Italian is pittore. So painter in Italian is pittore. Then we have cake baker. So those are the ones that are doing cake, and they are called pasticcere. If is male, is pasticcere, and if is a female, is pasticcera. So for male is pasticcere, and for female is pasticcera. Then we have photographer, which in Italian is fotografo. For male is photographo, and for female is photographer. So photographer in Italian for male is photographo, and for female is photographer. Then we have pilot, which in Italian is pilota. Pilot in Italian is pilota. Then we have plasterer, which in Italian is imbianchino. So in Italian is imbianchino. Imbianchino. Then we have plumber, which is idraulico. So plumber in Italian is idraulico. Then we have policeman or police officer, which is poliziotto for male, and for female is poliziotta. So for male is poliziotto, and for female is poliziotta. Then we have postman, which in Italian is postino for male, and for female is postina. So for male is postino, and for female is postina. Then we have professor, which in Italian is professore. For male, professor is professore, and for female is professoressa. Professoressa. I know it's a little bit long, but as I said previously, the more we practice, the more it's going to be easier. So professor in Italian for male is professore, and for female is professoressa. Then we have receptionist, which in Italian is called addetto, or addetto is for male, or addetta, which is for female, alla reception. So if is for male, the complete statement is, the complete word is addetto alla reception, and for female is addetta alla reception, or simply we can just say receptionist as the English word. Then we have secretary, which in Italian for male is segretario. So secretary for male in Italian is segretario, and for female is segretaria. So for female is segretaria. Then we have self-employed, which in Italian is lavoratore autonomo. So self-employed is lavoratore autonomo. So I had a lot of mistakes that many people are doing when it's come to this word, because many of us are saying autonomo, which autonomo in Italian is wrong. It's not called autonomo. I know it's used to say autonomo nowadays, but it's wrong. The right Italian word for this is autonomo. So it's lavoro autonomo. Then we have shoe ripiera, which in Italian is calzolaio. Shoe ripiera is calzolaio. Calzolaio. Then we have shop assistant, which is commesso for male, and for female is commessa. So for male is commesso, and for female is commessa. Then we have singer, which in Italian is cantante. Singer is cantante. Then we have tailor, which in Italian for the male is sarto. So tailor for the male in Italian language is sarto, and for the female is sarta. So for male is sarto, and for female is sarta. Then we have taxi driver, which in Italian taxi driver is tassista. Tassista. So in Italian language, taxi driver is tassista. Then we have teacher, which in Italian is insegnante. So teacher in Italian is insegnante. Then we have translator, which in Italian language, those who are translating are called traduttore. If it's male, is traduttore, and if it's a female, is traduttrice. So for male is traduttore, and for female is traduttrice. Then we have a waiter or waitress, and those are working in restaurants. So the waiter, which is for male, is cameriere. So waiter is cameriere, and waitress, which is for female, is cameriera. So waitress is cameriera. And those who are unemployed, so those that are without job, they are called disoccupato if it's male, and disoccupata if it's a female. So those who are unemployed for male, they are called disoccupato, and for the female, they are called disoccupata. So this is all for today. As I said previously, I will leave the pictures of the list in the comment section, so you can save it on your phone. And if you want the PDF to print it out and study it as well on a paper, you can contact me privately. So I hope I could help you and that you learned something from this video. And this was lesson 2. I'm going to also do lesson 3 in few days coming, and I'm going to upload it as well in my YouTube channel. So please, if you like it, please like the video, share it with your family and friends, and also subscribe in my YouTube channel. Thank you so much and have a nice day, and may God bless you.